Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and today we'll take a look at editing 360 video in Final Cut Pro. If you have a camera capable of recording 360 video, such as the GoPro Fusion, Insta OneX, or another 360 camera, after stitching your footage together, you can import it directly into Final Cut Pro and create your own 360 or virtual reality video. After your 360 video has been stitched together, import it into Final Cut Pro just like you would a normal clip. Next, create a new project and set the video format to 360. If you add your 360 video into your timeline, this is what it's going to look like. Not the result we want. I'll press Command-Z to undo that. Before adding your 360 video to your project timeline, first you have to specify the projection mode. Select your 360 clip in the media browser, and in the inspector, select the Info tab. Scroll down to Projection Mode setting, and select Equirectangular. You can now add your 360 clip to your project timeline, and the full clip will be displayed in your viewer, conformed to fit a regular video frame. Next, let's set up our workspace for editing 360 video. First, to free up some space, let's hide the media browser by using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Command+1, and hide the inspector by pressing Command+4. Now, bring up a 360 viewer by selecting View, Show in Viewer, and 360, or by using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Command+7. This brings up the 360 viewer with a much more normal looking angle of your clip. This is called the master orientation of your clip, and is the initial angle the viewers see when they start watching your video. You can change the master orientation of your clip a couple different ways. The most precise way to accomplish this is by using the reorient controls in the inspector. With your video clip selected, open up the inspector by pressing Command+4. Make sure the video inspector is selected, and you can adjust the master orientation of your clip with these parameters. Tilt or X-axis rotates the view up or down. Pan or Y-axis rotates your view left or right. And Roll or Z-axis rotates your view clockwise or counterclockwise. Final Cut Pro also includes horizon guidelines to help you recenter or level your image. In the viewer, from the View drop-down menu, in the Overlays section, select Show Horizon. You can now use your reorient parameters in the Video Inspector to help you realign, center, or level your image. You can also change the master orientation of your clip right in the viewer. Click the pop-up menu in the lower left of the viewer and choose Reorient. You can now click and drag your image in the viewer, not the 360 viewer, to adjust the master orientation of your clip. But as you can see, the viewer controls are not as precise as the controls in the inspector. Whichever controls you use, the main thing to remember is to level your horizon. This way, your audience will not get disoriented when watching your video, especially when using VR headsets. And finally, you can change the field of view of your master orientation by adjusting the slider at the top of the 360 viewer. Drag the slider to the right for a more narrower field of view, or left for a wider field of view. Down in your timeline, you can edit your 360 clip just like you would a normal clip. You can ripple trim your clip, blade it, move it around, pretty much anything you can do with a regular clip in your timeline. You can color grade your clip, or add any title, transition, or generator included in Final Cut Pro. Final Cut Pro does include some titles, generators, and transitions specially designed for use in 360 clips. These effects will always be projected correctly into an equirectangular projection. For example, to add a title designed for 360 video to your project, open up the Titles and Generators browser, select Titles, and from the drop-down menu, click the 360 category. Select your title, and drag and drop it down into your timeline. To adjust 360 titles, you have to do everything in the inspector. With your title clip selected, click on the Text Inspector tab, enter your text, and adjust the font, size, and appearance of your title. To reposition the title, select the Video Inspector, and just like for your 360 video clip, use the Reorient controls. If your title isn't visible in your master orientation, you can click and drag in the 360 viewer to reframe the shot to position your title. This simulates what your viewer will see when they either click and drag your video or move their VR headset. After you position your title, you can go back to your master orientation by selecting Reset Angle from the Settings drop-down menu. Generators and transitions designed for 360 video will also be in the 360 categories and are applied just like normal effects. Next week, we'll take a look at exporting and watching your 360 video, as well as sharing it online. If you haven't yet, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss it. Also, if you have any questions about 360 video, ask in the comments below, and I'll do my best to help you out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.